Forever and time. Oh, what we've been through, no one else knows. Cause all that matters is how far this goes. And it will go until it starts again. Oh, and you are good like armor. Nothing can stop love from loving on us.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Philip Parham Jr.
Asking for much, just a couple of forevers, a couple of forevers. I'm the only one, you're the only one, together to never. I'm talking about forever, just a couple.
I'm clearly taken by the Freakish, I'll tell y'all, me and PJ was arguing in front of my house, in front of the door. He broke the whole glass door. His mama made him pay for it. As soon as his mama paid for the door, mama will replace the door within a week. So his mama paid for the door for nothing. And mama was a little mad about it, but ever since then, me and PJ have been best friends. We've been inseparable. We've done everything together. Even when I went to the military, PJ was still there for me. Look at my children, he's been there for me the whole way. And Peter has a real great big heart. You know what I'm saying? He has a very big heart. But at the end of the day, I'm happy to be his best friend. Although he has other best friends here with him at the same way, even the people in the crowd. And I mean, I'm grateful that I was picked actually to be this person. I love my best friend. I wouldn't be nothing without him. I'm happy I'm here with him.
I just want to say to Deborah and PJ, I work with Deborah. Actually, she's my boss, one of my bosses. And over the last few years, I've really grown to love Deborah a lot, and she's a good friend. And God has just enabled us to come together and know each other, and I've been able to speak into her life. And so I'm honored to be your matron of honor. That is an honor for me, and I don't take that lightly. I've been praying for this day from the day Deborah and I first started talking, and she told me that you'd been together and you weren't married, and I've been praying, and so my prayer for you is that I know that God is gonna bless you tremendously now that you've made it right in
His sight. That's right, that's right.
And my prayer is that you don't look back, but you only look forward, and I pray the best for you, and I pray that you find a good church home together and worship God and keep Him first. And I love you, and I love your family. And Deborah, I love you with my whole heart. She's always, at work, I call her my daughter, even though she's my boss, because I love her like a daughter and a friend. And so I just love you. You're a beautiful bride. You're a beautiful couple. And may God bless you for many, many, many years.
Good evening. I'd like to thank everybody for coming. I'm PGA's father, as you see. Got it. First of all, PJ and Dee Dee, I want to congratulate you guys. I love you very much. Dee Dee, you know, you've been cool. I would like to thank Jimmy, okay? Jimmy is a very special guy to me, okay? I live in California. I know what it is to raise a child, okay? 16 years old, 17 years old is a nightmare, okay? So, unfortunately, PJ and Niecy and I didn't make it, but Niecy remarried Jimmy. I went to Jimmy's house. Jimmy welcomed me into his house like I was his son, okay? And I want to say that Jimmy and I together, along with Niecy, raised a great son. We love him. We love you, Dee Dee. May God be with you guys and wish you many, many years, okay? Love you much. Take care. Love you,
son. I'm PJ's sister. And on behalf of the Perm family, the Thompson family, the Winfield family, and the Valentine's family, you had them on that way for a long time. And you bought them, keep them.
I just want to say congratulations to my boy, PJ, and Judy. They're my best friend, my roommate. I live with both of them. And I've been there through the thick and thin, been a bit of advice to make it. I know you two good. You two can. Y'all keep on. You do your thing.
I'm TJ, PJ's brother. Me and PJ grew up together from birth. We were together forever. We always will be together forever. I love him. He's my older brother. And I just want to welcome Dee Dee to our family and Dee Dee family because now we all one big family. And we'll be together forever. I love everybody.
I would like to say that I'm very happy that my cousin PJ has gotten married. We look just alike. I love my cousin, man. And I'd like to thank Miss Perm for marrying my cousin. And we appreciate you for coming into our family, you know, and may God bless y'all. Bless you. I am so happy to be here today to see my grandson and his wife. I love both of them, and I pray to God that they will have a long, successful life and always hold on to God's hand, and He will bring you through. And I thank each and every one of you to take your time out to be here for this occasion today. It is just so kind of you, and may God bless each of you. Thank you so very much.
Hello, I am Lil and Everbearer, daughter. And mostly I love my dad. He's a lovely father. And mom, you are the best mom ever. I love you guys.
Come on. Go ahead, man. You can do it. You can do it.
The big thing about today is all about family. When we initially decided we wanted to get married, we were just going to keep it simple. Just do something small, dress us up easy, do something at home with the pastor. And as a family, we're all family. In number, I can say I got one of the biggest families ever, with the most last names ever. And as growing up, I never really paid attention to it. Everybody was a cousin or just around enough to make you think they're my cousin. And this has been a tough year for all of us. We went through this together. These same faces, I just saw in September. And we were crying for other reasons. Now we're together, crying and glory. But it's a joyous occasion. And we know that we got a couple people, not just one. A couple people watching down have been waiting on this too. And we share this moment with you all. As far as the wedding party, everybody that was selected to be in this wedding was selected for a reason. Everybody that was invited for a reason. Everybody that didn't get an invitation, but came for a reason. And I don't say that in a bad way, I would forgive it. You know, I didn't send everything. I can't remember all of y'all, because I just told you, I got a big family with a lot of last names. But I know if I sent out a few, the word was spread, and this would happen. This right here. If us together looking out on this makes it all worth it, you know. She was here. The dance floor would look like it looked. And when Sarah said she was here, she was on that dance floor. So as we leave today, as we part our ways, don't forget that we're still family. We need to continue this unit, continue to talk, communicate, get together on more than just a funeral or a wedding. I'd like to see y'all.
You the one that don't
feel
good.
And I give you my work number in case you can't get my cell phone. But, you know, I say all that to say that we love you all. We're so glad you all came. I know a lot of y'all waiting for this for a long time, and it's done, baby. We is married now.
She deserves it.
All I can say is just thank you. The love for you guys just comes in waves. And sometimes it's hard to take in. But when you get home and it gets quiet, those things give you peace. And I can say every night I go to sleep with peaceful thoughts. Because I know I got probably 50 moms, 60 uncles, 235 cousins. And now we're adding to the number with the Jones and the Maddox family. I'm really thankful for being here, and Didi didn't want to talk, but she got to talk.
Thank everybody for coming. I love all of y'all. For many more years, I just hope, you know, everything goes
good. It will.